Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about using arithmetic operators in C++. Let's get into it. All right, well, in this video, I'm going to be discussing five of the basic arithmetic operators that you'll see in C++, some rules regarding them, and some cool tricks that you can use. So, just a fair warning that this topic is somewhat dull and boring, but I'm going to try my best to keep it fresh and interesting. And if you can make it through this lesson, I would say that every lesson after this is going to be more interesting. So, let's begin. Let's go over the five basic arithmetic operators. The first is addition. And anytime you want to add something, you just use the plus symbol. Next, we have subtraction, and you use a minus symbol. I know, we've covered this in grade school, many years ago, but there's a few other arithmetic operators that you should really be aware of. First is multiplication. And do you remember back in math class where you would use x to multiply something? For example, like 5 times 5 is 25, and you use x to multiply? Well, in programming, we use the asterisk symbol. So use this anytime you want to multiply something. Next, we have division. And you use a forward slash anytime you want to divide something. And lastly, we have this thing called a modulus, and it's a percent sign. So the modulus is unique. It basically what it does is that if you divide two numbers, you have I believe it's called a dividend and a divisor, and you use the modulus between these two. And instead of giving you the quotient, it gives you the remainder. But don't fret right now if you don't quite understand what a modulus is. I'll give you an example of how it works and some practical applications of us using one. How about we go over an example of each of these? Sounds good, right? All right, let's get started. All right, so with addition, we could say something such as cout, and then this is an example of us using addition. We could say 5 plus perhaps 2, then semicolon, and this will just display the number 7. We're using cout to display whatever the result is, which is 7. So I'm going to comment this out and then just write this as an example. And when we're finished with this, I'll post this in the comments down below and pin it to the top if you would like a copy for notes or something. All right, so an example of us using subtraction, cout, then we need to use the insertion operator. Then we could say 5 minus 2. And then just display the result. And the result is going to be obviously 3. So let's turn that into a comment. All right, multiplication. We'll say cout. And then we could say 5 times 2. So remember, we don't use x for multiplication. We use the asterisk symbol for multiplication. And the result is going to be 10. So let's turn that into a comment. All right, so division. This is where it gets tricky. So cout, how about 5 divided by 2? So the answer should be 2.5, right? Well, that is actually not the case. The answer that we get is 2, and this is the reason why. It's this thing called integer division. So if you divide by a whole integer or something of the integer data type, it's not going to record that decimal portion and it gets truncated. So if we have 5 divided by 2, the result is going to be, 2.5, obviously, but it can't handle that decimal portion, so it just drops it or eliminates it. And we're stuck with the result of 2, which is not correct, but the computer thinks it's correct. So one trick that you can do is that you can change this to a decimal value or a double value. So if we were to say 5 divided by 2.0, this will actually save the decimal portion, and we are ending up with the result of 2.5. So make sure you remember that, because when you first start writing programs, you might not notice that you're using integer division and you might get an unexpected result. So be sure that if you're dividing by a certain value, make sure that it's a like double value or something with a decimal. And there's this concept called casting where you can convert from one data type to another, such as an integer to a double type. But for now, just make sure that if you're dividing and you want to keep the decimal portion, for the result, make sure that you're dividing by a number with a decimal. All right, so let's turn that into a comment and move on to modulus. Oh, quick note, so I decided to just do a little bit of formatting with these comments. I also added the results for each of these operations for our examples, just so you can have some notes to look at. And remember that I'll post this in the comments down below. Okay, so the modulus. The modulus works exactly like division, except instead of giving you a quotient as an answer, it's going to give you the remainder. For example, if we said C out 5 modulus 2, instead of displaying 2 or 2.5 if this is a decimal value or double value, it's actually going to display the remainder. So 5 does not divide by 2 evenly with integer division, so it's going to give us a remainder of 1. And this is actually useful if you need to determine if a number is even or odd, because if you place the number that you want to examine here, then use modulus 2, if it divides evenly by 2, this result is actually going to be 0. So let's try it out. So 4 divided by 2 gives us a remainder of 0. And when we get to if statements, we could say, if the result is equal to 0, then this number is even. However, if this number, modulus 2, is equal to 1, then it's going to be an odd number. But I'll show you a program like that maybe in the future for a different example. But that's one practical application of how using a modulus would be useful, because you can determine if a number is even or odd. If you put your number here, then use modulus 2. So let's turn that into a comment and then move on to something else. So we'll say result equals 1, because that's the remainder. My next topic for this video, we will be discussing the use of the increment and the decrement operators. So with programming, we do a lot of counting. In fact, we do so much counting that we have our own operator that's specifically designed for counting up or down by a certain number. So let's say that we have an integer variable named total, and let's just set this equal to perhaps 1. Alright, so let's say that we want to add 1 to whatever this total is. Well, we would normally have to write a statement such as total equals total plus 1. And then we can display whatever the new total is. So if we were to run this, 1, which is the total, plus 1 equals, of course, it's going to be 2. Alright. So, since we do so much counting with programming, we have a shorthand way of writing a statement such as this if we need to increment something by 1. So instead of saying total equals total plus 1, what you just do is say total plus plus. And this will do the exact same thing. We will add 1 to whatever the total currently is, or whatever variable you're working with. So this works just the same. Now, the opposite of this is the decrement operator. So we could say total minus minus, and this is the same as saying total equals total minus 1. So we could say total minus minus, and this will decrement something by 1 each time we use this. So the result here would end up being 0. Now you can increment or decrement by a given value. So with total plus plus, this increments by 1. If you want to increment by, let's say, 2, you can do something else. You could say total plus equals 2, and this will count up by 2. So the result here would be 3. And if you were to say total minus equals 2, this will subtract or count down by 2. And the result here would be negative 1. So let's add that to our notes. The increment operator, we can take a value or variable and just say plus plus right after the end. And then let's do the same thing for the decrement operator. So we'll say x minus minus. So use the increment operator if you want to add 1 to something, to some number or variable. And then use the decrement operator if you want to subtract 1 from a value or variable. Alright, well, next on my agenda, I have to teach you guys about typecasting, because I said I would mention that. Now what I'm going to do is copy this statement here where I say C out 5 divided by 2.0, but let's change that to 2. All right, so normally this results in the answer being 2 because with integer division, we can't handle that decimal portion, so that gets cut off or truncated. So we have a few options to work with if we want our answer to retain that decimal portion in the answer when we're using any sort of integer division. The first is that we would need either our dividend or our divisor to have a decimal portion. They can be of the float data type or the double data type. So if we said 5 divided by 2.0, we would end up keeping that decimal portion with our answer here. Otherwise, the dividend can also be a float or a double data type. And this would work just the same. You can do it either way. Another option is this concept called casting. So you can convert a number that's of one data type to another. And what you do before that number is that within parentheses, you just write the data type that you want to convert this number or variable into. So with this whole integer of 5, we can convert this to, let's say, a double. And if we were to run this, the result is going to be 2.5, and we end up keeping that decimal portion. Now check this out. What if we put our dividend and our divisor within its own set of parentheses around this part of the equation, and then we cast this afterwards? Well, what's going to happen is that it's actually going to take 5 divided by 2 first, and then it's going to truncate the decimal and then cast it to a double, and we still lose that decimal part of this answer. Likewise, you can take a result that's normally a double and you can cast it into an integer data type intentionally so you can purposefully cut off the decimal portion. So an example of this is that we'll say C out perhaps 5.051 divided by 2.021. I'm just making up numbers here. Let's comment this out. So normally this dividend divided by this divisor equals 2.49926. All right, let's say that we want to cut off the decimal portion or truncate it. Well, what we'll do is that we'll put this within parentheses and we're going to take the result and cast this of the integer data type. So our result is that it's going to be just 2 then. Before we move on, I'm just going to add a note that says cast to a double, cast to an int. All right, so we finally made it to the final topic of this video, and we need to cover operator precedence. So do you guys remember in grade school where if we have a multi-part equation such as this with multiple different arithmetic operators, each of these operators has a certain precedence one over another? And what we learned in grade school was this acronym. It was PEMDAS. And one way of remembering this, which was kind of silly, is that we would say, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, or something very similar to that, that used the same letters for this acronym. And what this meant is that we would solve anything within parentheses first, followed by exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and then lastly subtraction. So if we were to solve this using this order of operations, PEMDAS, we would solve, let's see, 2 times 3 first, because any multiplication takes precedence over addition. So 2 times 3 is 6 plus 1. The result is going to be 7 then. So we have a different set of rules for programming. And it's actually a little bit more simple, I would say, than PEMDAS. So with programming, we solve anything within parentheses first for step 1. Step 2, we do any multiplication or any division. It doesn't matter which one comes first. We always start from the left and work to the right. And then step 3, we do any addition or subtraction at the very end. All right, so here's an example. So if you want, why don't you pause the video and see if you can guess what the total is going to be? And I'll just walk you through these steps using our order of operations for programming. So step one, we have to solve anything within parentheses first, and we start from the left and work our way to the right. So the only place that I see parentheses is at the very end. So we're going to solve everything within here first. So we're going to say 6 plus 7 first, which is 13. All right, so we can get rid of these parentheses then because they're no longer relevant. Step two, we need to do any multiplication and division first. So we start from the left and work our way to the right. I see 3 times 4, so we need to solve that first. All right, so then we have 12 divided by 5.0, and I changed this from 5 to 5.0 because of integer division. So this is going to be 12 divided by 5 is 2.4, so let's change that. All right, so there is no more multiplication or division, so we do any addition or subtraction. So 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 minus 2.4 is 0.6, so 0.6 plus 13 is 13.6. All right, so let's go back to see if that actually was the answer. All right, so let's run this. We probably need to display what the total is going to be. And the answer is 13.6. Well, good job making it to the end. I knew this was a somewhat more dull topic, but it was necessary for us to nail down some of these basics. And if you want a copy of what we did here today, I'm going to post it as a comment down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started working with just basic arithmetic in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.